Happy Mother's Day.
Welcome to Greenock United Methodist Church. I am Pastor Lori Walter. For anyone out there, not you all here, out there who do not know me, we welcome you to worship our Lord together. A few announcements before we begin. Trustees will meet tomorrow. Nominations Committee will meet the 18th. Washington District Conference is Sunday, May 21st at 1 o'clock at Boyce Road campus. I need to know who is going, so if you are going, if you could let me know. You may see there is the bird bath is out. The bird bath out front means we're collecting money. The youth of the church, mostly the confirmation class and their mentors, are going to Juwan Guilford overnight on June 10th and 11th. I thought, that's pretty good, you all know that. We're going to Juwanville, and then the next day on the 12th, we will have confirmation service here during our worship service. But we need money to get to Juwanville. So if the Spirit leads you, please leave something in the bird bath. But we are raising money. We are having a bake sale. And if anyone would like to contribute baked goods for us to sell, and we will set up outside like we did a few years ago. We will have our baked goods and lemonade, and we will sell a few things to so that we can get to Juwanville. We will be able to have communion at the foot of the cross, and it's just we have a good time. We have a good time, and they learn so much about themselves and each other and about our Lord Jesus Christ. On June 12th, please plan to be here in worship on June 12th. Our district superintendent, Ross Pryor, will be preaching the message that day. He'll give you a chance to meet our new district superintendent and to get to know him and talk with him afterwards. So please plan to be here. Vacation Bible School is June 20th to the 25th. If you would like to help, we are having a planning meeting on May 9th of tomorrow. Tomorrow at 1 o'clock. Even if you can't be there, you can still help. So if you are available during the summer and during the day, come on, help. And we could use all the help. We are having a church conference May 24th. There is an issue before us, and there will be a letter going out this week to explain everything to you so that you can think about this and you're not presented with it that night and then say, okay, vote. You'll have a chance to ponder all of this, to ask any questions ahead of time. And this concerns the property over here, the back lot of our adjoining property where the church house that's here, the yard that's up here, selling that yard to the neighbor. And if you have any questions about this, you want to ask ahead of time, Don Frank is our expert on this matter. Compared to the rest of us, he knows all. But I will be sending out a letter this week. Don and I will comprise this letter to give you information. But the church needs to vote on it. It is not the trustees who vote. It is not the council who votes. All members of good standing will vote. If you want to become a member before then, come and see me. Ascension, the Ascension of Our Lord worship service, May 26th, is a Thursday evening service down at Peace Lutheran Church. We've been invited to come and worship with them on that day. They called us and invited us specifically. Monet in Bloom. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited about this. This Saturday, there's a group of us going down to Fiction Conservatory, and they have the Monet and Bloom exhibit. If you like Monet, he's my favorite painter, and yes, he is my favorite. I know there are others I like, but he's my favorite. Then we're doing that then. Please silence your cell phones. Don't forget prayer group and meet me on the front porch. This is our time together to study, to talk, to pray. Come join us. Just think of all the times that group has prayed for you. It was there to pray for you. Chosen, we will not be meeting today since it's Mother's Day, but we will come back next week and see episode 2 of season 2. Do we have any other announcements? Christ is our shepherd, who knows us and calls us. Our shepherd gives us eternal life that no one can take away from us. So let us come and worship his holy name.
Please join me for the call of worship. Christ is our shepherd.
We are Christ's sheep.
The shepherd is calling us to join God's call.
We will follow our shepherd.
Rejoice, little one, for no one can snatch us from the shepherd's hand.
In God's flock, we rest yours.
Come, let us worship. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Loving the shepherd,
in the midst of sorrow and loss, you wipe away every tear from our eyes. May the wonders of your love reach down to us this day. May the world see the shepherd living in us, and may it become to dwell in your pastures, which remain evergreen. Amen.
The hymn of praise is Since Jesus Came in.
Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Honor her for all that her hands have done, and let her work bring her praise at the city gate. We honor our mothers, both with us and not. We do. And we give presents. But the gifts, the tokens, are not what a mother desires. It is your presence. Whether you can be with your mother today, or whether it needs to be by phone, or maybe just a little time off, your presence matters most to a mother. Speaking as a mother, I know that's true. The trinkets you get, the gifts you get, they are wonderful. They are appreciated because they come from you. But being there, calling, speaking to your mother. Herbert Farnham said, God took the fragrance of a flower, the majesty of a tree, the gentleness of a morning dew, the calm of a quiet sea, the beauty of a twilight hour, the soul of a starry night, the laughter of a rippling brook, the grace of a bird in flight. Then God fashioned from these things a creation like no other, and when his masterpiece was through, he called it simply mother. Let us pray. Dear Father, we approach your throne on behalf of the mothers whom you have entrusted with the care of your most precious little one. We thank you for creating each mom with a unique combination of gifts and talents. We thank you for the sacrifice of each mom that each mom gives for her children. We thank you for the gift of time moms give for their kids, and whether it's a stay-at-home mom, working mom, or moms who have the combination of the two. We thank you for the flexibility of moms, for their tirelessness, their perseverance, and their devotion. We pray you give each mother strength. Help her to see every mundane task as eternal cosmic significance that you place on motherhood. We pray for single moms who must lean solely on you for the fathering of their children. We thank you that your big arms surround children who may never know their earthly mothers. We also pray for mothers who have never had the honor of bearing children, but whose nurturing extends to the many poor and needy who cross the threshold of their lives. We ask you to be the daily bread of tired mothers. We ask you to be their living water. We ask you to be their source of spiritual and physical strength. We pray that the same grace that flowed from the Father to the Son to us in salvation will flow from mothers to their children. May each mother find rest in you. Most of all, dear Lord, on this day in which we honor mothers, may we love and cherish the special women who have borne us, have nurtured us, and who have prayed for our well-being. May our hearts overflow with gratitude to you, who formed and knitted each of us in our mother's womb. Amen. So happy Mother's Day to all of you, for even if you don't have your own children, we know that you have helped someone with theirs.
Today is Psalm 30, reading through Psalm 23, and we'll be reading this responsibly. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
The Lord brings me to thy bound in green pastures.
Leads me beside still waters, restores my life.
Leads me in right paths for the sake of the Lord's name.
Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil.
For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies.
You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for as long as I live.
The New Testament lesson will be Acts 9, verses 36. and much Greek is Dorcas. She was devoted to good works and acts of charity. At the time, she became ill and died. When they had washed her, they laid her in the room upstairs. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples, who heard that Peter was in there, sent two men to him and with a request, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter got up and went to them, and when he arrived, they took him to the room upstairs. All the widows stood beside him, weeping and showing tunics and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was with them. Peter pulled all of them outside, and he knelt them down and prayed. He turned to the body and said, "Tabitha, get up." Then she opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hand and helped her up. Then calling the saints and widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. Meanwhile, he stayed in Joppa some time with a certain Simon, a tanner. The choir anthem will be "Blessed Be the Name of the Lord."
Thank you.
Our gospel reading this morning comes from, we're going backwards now, we're going back in time, before the crucifixion and the resurrection. We're reading from John 10, 22-30. And if you are able, and out of your body or spirit, would you please stand as we hear the word of our Lord. The festival of the dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter. And Jesus was walking in the temple in the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly." Jesus answered them, "I have told you, and you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name testify to me. But you do not believe, because you do not belong to my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of my Father's hand. The Father and I are one." This is the word of God for the people of God. Please be seated in the presence of our Lord. There's a third grade Sunday school class, and they were learning the 23rd Psalm. They had 2 weeks to learn it. They had to recite it back to their teacher at the end of 2 weeks to prove that they have heard it, that they have learned it. On the day of the test, Sally sat nervously, waiting for her turn, for she had not practiced. She did not memorize the 23rd Psalm. When it was her turn to get up after all the kids stood up and they did so well, Sally stood up and she shifted. "The Lord is my shepherd, and that's all I need to know." And she sat down. How true is that? The Lord is our shepherd, and that's all we need to know. So why don't we believe it all the time? Why don't we trust in that? Now, the 23rd Psalm was written for the metaphorical sheep of the world. Jesus used sheep. Why? Because they knew sheep. Today, I wonder what Jesus would use to speak to us. What would we follow? But at the time, it was sheep. They trusted the one who cared for them, who tended their lives, fed them, and protected them. Peace was restored to a sheep when the shepherd walked in. When the shepherd would go home or go eat or go do something, the sheep were very nervous. They had to watch around them for danger. But when the shepherd came back and they heard his voice, they calmed down. They gathered around whose voice they knew. It's amazing that if you do go to where they have many sheep, one person will speak and certain sheep would run to this person. In Europe, they had gathering places where everyone would put their sheep, but they didn't have to separate them. For the shepherd would come out and say, "Come on, sheep, let's go." And his sheep would come out and follow him, and others would stay back there because they didn't know him. But when their shepherd came out, they followed him. They say it's really an amazing thing to witness. You would have hundreds of sheep dividing themselves, following their shepherd. I think that's why Jesus used the shepherd. That when we hear his voice, his sheep come to follow. We know the difference between Jesus and a false prophet. We know the difference between the Word of God and what the world wants. We know the voice of our Lord, and we follow. We want for nothing when we follow the shepherd's voice. Our lives are not stress-free because we do live here. And God never said, I will protect you from everything. But the shepherd said, I will be with you through everything. I will give you strength. I will give you comfort and peace. And the peace that surpasses all our understanding will flow over us just like the sheep, and they calm down when they see their shepherd. We can get that peace to calm us through all the stresses of the world. And we've been reading from the Gospel of John the past few weeks, from Easter on, and I forgot, Happy Easter, everyone. You know it is still Easter. It is still Easter till a certain day. Does anybody know the day? So we are, Easter is not a day. Resurrection Sunday is the day. Easter is a season. Just like I do at Christmas. It's still Christmas. It is still Easter. But we're going before the Easter season, when Jesus told them plainly, I have told you and told you, I and the Father are one. What I do are acts of the Father through me. You've witnessed it, yet you still do not believe. We have the Bible. We've witnessed through the teachings, through the writings. And yet, there are so many who do not believe. But the good shepherd's sheep will follow. So we go from the sheep of the past to the sheep of our present. We are the sheep today. We who are dirty, sinful, lost, roaming around aimlessly because we do not have a shepherd. And we, I mean, as the world. The world's shepherd was taken away when we were not allowed to bring up Jesus or God in the schools, in the workplace. Anywhere outside the church, we're not supposed to talk about our God. The world is removing the shepherd from the sheep. So there are so many sheep who are lost. So many sheep who are roaming this earth, searching for something, just like the disciples were searching for the Messiah, searching for a change when they found Jesus. Today, people are still searching. People are out there looking for something to make sense in this world. Yet they still don't turn to our Lord. So as sheep, we keep each other safe. Maybe we need to go look to the sheep next to us, the one who's roaming, and say, hey, come be part of our flock. Now Jesus went from the good shepherd, and he taught his sheep. So then his sheep left the flock that they were close with, and they went out to be the shepherds. Peter, you know, he had doubts, he had fears, and yet he still went. He denied knowing Jesus, and he still went. And he went to all the places, and now that Jesus was not there to perform these miracles, people turned to Peter. Well, we know Peter's nearby. We've seen he has performed miracles as well in the name of Jesus Christ. So they called for him when Tabitha became ill and passed away. Now Tabitha heard the voice of the shepherd that was left behind to tend to them. And she opened her eyes and she sat up. Jesus told her to sit up, to come back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. So Peter did not bring her back to life. The Lord brought Tabitha back to life through the name of Jesus. And all who were there began to believe. Tabitha believed because in the first line it says she devoted herself to Christ, his actions. All her deeds surrounded Jesus Christ. She believed so that when the Lord called on her to wake up, she woke up without a fear. She came back without concern, for she knew. She knew her shepherd's voice. Jesus calls us to be that committed, to listen for the shepherd's voice, whether it is from Jesus Christ himself, the great shepherd, or when God calls those to be the shepherds and lead the flock. There was a pastor who was teaching the children the 23rd Psalm, and he was telling them about the sheep, that the sheep were not smart, that they needed lots of guidance, and that the shepherd's job was to stay close to the sheep, that the shepherds were now the people left in charge to protect the sheep, to teach them about the good shepherd, to protect them from doing dumb things like going off and getting hurt or killed or following someone else. He pointed to the children in the room and he said, "You are all the sheep. Did you know that? You're the sheep." And with an eyebrow raised, he said, "Did you know who I am?" He was confident that he had told the children enough that they would know who he was in this scenario. And one little boy yelled, or he said, "Who is the shepherd here?" That was his question. Who is the shepherd? And a little boy yelled, "Jesus!" He says, "Yes, you're right. Jesus is the good shepherd. Who then am I?" And another little boy looked at him and said, "Well, I guess you're the sheepdog." We are the sheepdog. We run around. We gather. We are called to run around and gather the sheep together, to bring them into the flock, to bring them into the fold of Jesus' arm. So we are to be like the sheepdog and run around and surround people, explaining who Jesus is, that they don't have to search anymore. They can find comfort in the arms of the Good Shepherd, and we are to bring them home. That is our role. Maybe the Bible tells us that, you know, go out and tend my sheep, as Jesus, we heard last Sunday, when Jesus called Peter and reminded him, "Do you love me? Then tend my sheep." Right there, Jesus passed on the role. You will be the shepherd now. Tend my sheep. So now we are to go out and bring others to Jesus Christ, to bring them all, bring all the sheep to the good shepherd. We've had the shepherds of the past, like Abraham. Abraham was afraid but took on this commitment and traveled far away from home into the promised land where God wanted his flock to live, where the great nation of Israel would begin. And he called Moses, and Moses, you know, Moses sat there, "Lord, I don't want to." But God told him, "I will help you. I will give you the words. I will give you Aaron to help you." He called on Peter and Tabitha and all those around to go out and bring in the sheep. And now he calls us. We are to go out and gather the sheep, just like the people before you. Who were the shepherds in your life? Now we know the shepherds who stood up here. We know Pastor David Morris. We know all the, We know all the others who were here before and after him. And all those who will come after me. Those are the ones who tend this flock in this church, but then you are the shepherds who are called to go out. And who were the examples? Who were the shepherds here? Who were the people who sat right where you are sitting right now? You have taken their place. You are called to go out and bring others to sit where you are sitting. That is our role today. Whether they are the Sunday school teachers, the administrators, the leaders of the church, we are all called to do this. Now, there was a rescue station at the beach. And one day, the tide was high, and they probably had the flags out not to go in the water. But people don't always follow the rules of the flags. So people were in the ocean, and the waves were crashing, and the lifeguards, the poor lifeguards, were working tirelessly to go out and save the people who did not heed the warnings. All day long, they went out and brought someone else back in. A man was sitting there watching, and he watched all these rescues, and he didn't want to go home because right when he'd start to leave, something else would happen. So he waited, and he watched. And he was going to the command center for the lifeguards. He wanted to commend them for their efforts that day, for working tirelessly, wondering why they continued to do it when these people were told not to go into the water. They were warned it's dangerous. Why would they continue to save all these people at their own risk? But he walked into the rescue station, and the first thing he saw on the wall was this giant sign that said, "When in doubt, go." That should be hanging here. If you're not sure someone knows Jesus, go. Go tell them. When you're not sure that there's a situation, an accident, that someone needs to hear the name of Jesus Christ, that they're not alone, go tell them. We are called to go out to all the lost sheep of the world. Every church should have that sign, when in doubt, go. So we are to listen to the voice of the Good Shepherd, the Holy Spirit that will lead us to each situation where we should go. We need to know the name of Jesus Christ ourselves, assured that he is one with the Father. And that's all we need to know to go. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord never leaves us. And the Lord will be with each one. And he will never lead us into a situation that we cannot handle in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We have many, many prayer requests this day. Please keep Tom in your prayer that he came home. And Dan is calling the doctor today. Something's wrong. So we're waiting to hear from Dana as to what's happening with Tom. I ask that you keep Zach Brewster in prayer as he has COVID, and for his parents, I hope they don't get it. Continued prayers for Jerry. And Dick and Doris would be here. Don't be concerned. today that Dick's not here, that something's wrong. There are still roads closed because of flooding, because of all the rain that has fallen in this past week. They tried two different ways to get here and called and said, we give up, we're going home. So prayers for all those who cannot get where they're going because of all the road closures and the trees down, for the family of the man in Bethel Park who a tree fell on their car, for the others who were in the accident, they were not hurt, but it fell right on the driver's side and he was killed. Prayers for that family. You see the many, many names before us, the many names on our list. Let's look at our joys. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Carol. It is today. We have a birthday today. Darlene's is tomorrow. Nick's is the 10th. Cindy Lou's the 12th. Good grief, we have a big birthday.
My brother-in-law, Don Kunkel, thanks for the continued prayers. He's still, it's been well over a month, he still can barely stand. So, from them leaving him in a bed for so long, and then the rehab did not get him out of bed like they were supposed to, and my sister got him home, but she is trying to do it on her own to get him moving and physical therapy, and she's doing it. They got him to stand for 4 minutes, and they were rejoicing. So he's struggling.
Well, that's great that they were rejoicing for that.
Yeah.
I was wondering.
Take them one day at a time.
Charlie?
Yeah, play for Ray Plum.
Please keep Ray Plum in prayer. And I ask, we have Jackie on here, but keep Jackie in prayer, that we're thrilled to see the two of you. We keep Jackie in prayer and your sister Beth. For Jackie and Beth. Thank you. Do we have Lois?
We need prayers for Cindy Lou, who's having a procedure on Wednesday.
Cindy Lou.
It will be fine.
Cindy Lou has been. We have been keeping her in prayer because of the cancer that she overcame. So we continue to lift her up in prayer, but now there are test results that need further investigation, and she will have
to call herself. and everything will be okay.
Yeah. So please keep Cindy Lou in prayer as she has her procedure this Wednesday. And it will be all okay. She's in the arms of our Lord. And no matter what comes, God is with her. But we are praying it will all be okay. Cindy.
Our friend Perry Rossetti has cancer, and he's having the not so good side effects, and he was not working in this one, so we have to switch things on.
What's his first name?
Mario.
For Mario Rossetti, we have lifted in prayer before, but now the treatments are not working well. So they have to find what will work. So please keep Mario in prayer. Do we have others? Are there any blessings out there?
My great-granddaughter was in church today.
Yes.
She made it almost through the whole circus.
Yes. I don't know if they're in there.
But that's one of the best parts of being a mother. Someday you'll be a great-grandmother.
And you can just sit in church.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Praises to the children. It's great to see Lilith here. It's great to hear Lilith and see her playing. She did not need to leave. But I understand that. The praises for children all everywhere. Pam.
I've been blessed with a new job. I've been nursing 35 years and recently left the county, but I'm with UPMC Mental Health, Drug and Alcohol, and the people I work with, I am just so blessed. I thank God every day.
How wonderful.
Yeah, and the help, and it's different, but blessed.
Praise God. Pam, God led you to a new job, one where your skills are needed, where your love is needed, and God has truly blessed Pam.
Yeah, and I say it'll be fine when I do the no one.
Well, that's good. Okay, do we have
joy that they're back in church?
Yes, it is so good to see you here.
You.
Back in church. There are no others.
We have sunshine.
No worries. Yes. And we have. I have a song in my head now, but I won't sing it. Sunshine. Yes, the earth does need the rain. I don't know if it needs that much rain all at once. But we have sunshine today. So this reminds us to be thankful. You know, if we had sunshine every day, would we be as thankful for it? It reminds us to be thankful for all the wonderful gifts we are given. And sunshine definitely is a gift. So let's come together to our Father and let's pray. Almighty God, You are. Everything about you is wondrous and magnificent and powerful. And we praise your name this sunny Sunday morning as we come to read your holy word, to praise your holy name, to come before you with our request for healing, for peace, and for comfort. Father, our list grows each week. We have many, many on our list. And Lord, we pray. We know you're with them. But they may not know that you're with them. So Lord, we pray that your presence would be felt in their lives. Your presence will be known. That your saving grace will be felt. We pray, Lord, that we, as your sheep, go out to be shepherds for others. We pray that what we say and what we do will lead those who are lost. For Lord, this is a world full of lost sheep. It is full of people searching for something better, yet Lord, for some reason they don't turn. turned to you, and we just don't understand why. But maybe it's because no one went to tell them that the Good Shepherd is here. The Good Shepherd is with them. So lead us, Lord. Use your Spirit to guide us where to go, what to do, and what to say, that we may honor you always. Father God, specifically we lift up this day for Jackie and Beth, for Tom and Zach and Ray and Riley and Mario. Be with them. Be with them, we pray. Be with the mothers of today, for Lord, it's not an easy job. You are our mother. You are our father. You're the great parent to whom we turn for guidance. Lead us in all our interactions with our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren. Knowledge of what to do. May the children know the difficult job that is before their mother. The young mothers and old mothers alike, the job does not end. It brings us great joy. It brings us heartache. So Father God, we rely on you to be the mothers you want long for us to be. So we come to you with all of our prayers. We call on you to surround Cindy Lou this day for her procedure that we don't hear about the worst case scenario because it's not there. That you will hold her and touch her body, giving her strength. Tom as well. And we do this with confidence, Lord, because we trust in you as we lift our voices as your children and pray to you as our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We have said the Good Shepherd provides everything that we need. So now we show the shepherd that we trust, and we bring those gifts back. So let us come before the Lord. Let us give all that we can. And you'll notice today is the return of the green baskets. The green baskets, it's been 2 years since we put them away because of COVID. But they're back. If you have any change in your pocket or your purse, and they hold dollar bills too. And these are the green baskets. We will put that money toward Vacation Bible School. So let us come and give our gifts to the Lord.
Thank you.
Loving Shepherd, we thank you for your tender care. Everything we have comes with the goodness of your love. Receive the gift and return to you now, that sheep and other flocks may come to know you and discover that you are the one who laid down your life for the flock. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. I want to thank all who come up and do this job of literacy each week. We are truly blessed. Now let us come together and sing our final hymn. His name is Wonderful. Just go. Amen.